I was trying to do an experiment with which I wanted to test whether I could change an oscillator by adding charge to a capacitor in a tank circuit. And of course change the oscillator, change the frequency of that oscillator, and then try to find the relation between the charge added to the capacitor and the frequency. Well, that was not very successful. I found some effects, but anyway, I found another interesting effect. I did this experiment at first with crystals, a few crystals here, because the crystal has a very stable frequency, and my idea was to say add some charge to a crystal. A crystal is in fact kind of tank circuit. It has capacitance, and on the basis of adding some charge, try to find out whether the frequency changed. I cannot tell much about these experiments because they were not successful. A little bit successful, but not conclusive. That's another issue. But I made the oscillator again that I made many times, and it's here. And I found out that I could change the frequency with the help of two potentiometers. And that was very peculiar. I had done that experiment many times before without success. But here you see these two potentiometers. One is 1 megaohm. The other is 1 kilo ohm. They are here. And I want to tell more about the principles as far as I can understand them. The tank circuit, 28 turns. This is my tank circuit. 28 turns on yellow PVC, diameter 16 millimeters. This is also important, the coil. I've published this circuit much more, but anyway, 300 windings, a pair on my meter here, this one from China. I have read that it was 0.1 microhenry. That doesn't tell so much, but the DC ohms resistance is 8 ohms wound on isolation material. Here, isolation material of a massive copper wire, and that isolation material is 3 millimeters. And that's the whole setup. At first I want to show the effect that I found, perhaps not very important and well known and etc. Good explainable via the classic radio theory, etc. This is the 1 megaohm potentiometer, the 1K potentiometer, and here we see what happens when I turn that 1K potentiometer. The amplitude goes somewhat up. That's not the issue where it's all about. It's all about the frequency. The frequency changes somewhat. And you can see that here on the counter. I change now the 1K potentiometer. And the frequency changes somewhat. And it is done without a variable capacitor. In a certain way, you can say we add this capacitor that bridges the tank circuit, in fact, more or less to the tank circuit with the help of resistors. Again, I had no success in the past with this setup, but this worked. So it's interesting, I think. And the peculiar thing is that we have here a 1 mega ohm resistor that is connected here from the trimmer to ground. This is the tank circuit. These two values here set the frequency from the trimmer to ground. And another variable potentiometer that varies within this range that is set here by this one. Within a certain range, this potentiometer varies the, say, resistive effect. That's what I want to call it. So when we set this, say the preset, that 1 mega ohm to another part of its ohms scale, you can see this. Now I turn the 1k potentiometer and you don't see any frequency change, or not any, but a slight frequency change. But when you turn that 1 mega ohm potentiometer in another position, you see a real, not big, but a real frequency change. So that's very interesting, this phenomenon. I did this experiment in the past many, many times. Anyway, I have to say, the whole setup, and that's all about the principles. These are the principles. The whole setup works only, or in a certain way, only on the somewhat higher frequencies. Because on higher frequencies in the shortwave band, small value capacitors, and they are in fact here over the tank circuit, have more effect on the frequency. And there is no success with this circuit when that tank circuit has already a parallel capacitor. When you do this experiment, you will see almost no change in frequency, and even, say, destructive oscillations. And I mean that the oscillations cancel out each other. That's very strange. Here is a kind of frequency present with when there is a fixed value capacitor. And when you add this part of the circuit and change the resistance value, you will see that the oscillation stops on a certain moment. That happens on low frequencies, in low shortwave frequencies, say 2 MHz, and also on higher frequencies. But when there's no parallel capacitor, this setup, this part of the circuit, is responsible for the resonance effect. Of course, many other phenomena are there, but anyway. So, less success on lower shortwave frequencies. In that case, you can try to make, of course, this capacitor bigger. But on the lower frequencies, that doesn't work so well. You will have, that's my, on the basis of my earlier experiments, more quick a situation where the waveforms cancel each other out. When you want to try to use a resistor to switch in a certain way a parallel capacitor to a tank circuit on and off, or give that capacitive unit here a kind of effect on the frequency, that doesn't work so well. So, this was already told anyway. So, there's not so much more to tell about this circuit. I want to go further with the other experiments, especially about charge. try to find a very simple method to measure very tiny currents with the help of an oscillator. And that was the first setup, etc. By the way, the whole circuit also works as a crystal oscillator, though there is, I found very strange results, or whatever results, these crystals all worked on their frequencies between, say, 3 megahertz and 6 megahertz, and many other crystals of exactly the same frequency did not work. So, it's useful as a crystal oscillator. And of course, when you use a crystal, remove the tank circuit, remove this whole part of the circuit, and then connect your crystal from the gate of the field effect transistor to ground. And I found that it worked better with a 1 mega ohm potentiometer, a fixed value resistor. And that's here because in the earlier stage I did my experiments with this circuit and here that crystal. So, perhaps it's useful. The frequency variation is approximately 380 kilohertz on 4 megahertz. That's also important, of course, when you have another frequency, resonance frequency of the oscillator. You will find another variation in the frequency that can be set with these two potentiometers.